Today I'm going to talk about process of research-based output. The title appears to be different, but true. It's all about thesis, dissertation, report, study report, MPhil, or research paper, or even PhD. So it's the first one in 21, so the title is Title 121. Okay, most of us are confused or get lost or confront in finalizing the title of our work, and that is a big trouble these days with students and scholars. So here we are. When you really want to go for a title, look at this. This is a label of single malt Scotch whiskey, a very age-old business. I have purposefully chosen this label because here you can put the establishment year that is celebrated, age of your whiskey, and then your name here, which will be your own name. Now, why I put this here is that generally when you buy a bottle, you look at the label, and from the label you make out what could be there inside the bottle. And now please come and look at this bottle. Once you remove the label, what remains is that you can see here a bottle full of dirt water. So very simple thing to understand is that, do you want your work to be recognized like a dirt water in this bottle, or you want a real respect like a single malt Scotch whiskey where your name would be there, age, everything is there. Fun apart, that is what happens when you do a lot of hard work and you do a lot of spade work. You fight and you struggle, you do library work and so many things you do, but somehow your title doesn't give justification to your work, and rather it confuses and misleads the evaluator. So chances for students are that they lose marks and they fail to convince the people that how hard they have really worked. So it's a question of credibility of a student also, even not necessarily just postgraduate students, but I feel PhD students also face this problem. So titles and acknowledgements. Why are titles important? Are they important? Yes, titles are important. What makes a good title? What makes a good title? That is also very important. How a good title can be really formed? And then what belongs in the acknowledgements? Because the title would come along with the concept of acknowledgement also. Here also in this particular thing, you see that there is a lot of acknowledgement put here. The word Scotland, you know, every single word has some history, some importance or something like that. Not only here in the label, but the purpose of using this visual is to make you understand the very importance of title, choice of words, and how we really go about it. So in this entire process, we should understand that why titles are important. The title is the first thing a reader sees. A boring title turns the reader away. A good title may determine whether or not to read. That happens, and that is happening with you also on YouTube and Google and so many things. A good title will spark the attention. It grabs hold of the audience and prompts the reader to look more closely. That is what happens with a good cover of a book and especially good title. If the title is not that good, you can understand that the pickup of the book, or what they call in marketing as point of purchase, is the first failure in such cases. Titles are always important. We should understand when we are working that our work needs to be justified in terms of, you know, how we really want to be justified. You are doing this work for your degree, for some marks. When you do post-graduation, your work like summer internship projects or any other projects, you show them to your employer and they read and they go through it. So each and every word they look at it as your contribution, little contribution in your studying time. But if the title is wrong and it turns out to be, you know, looking like a whiskey, but inside there is a drainage water like that, you can understand what bad impression you must be creating to the employer or the evaluator. What makes a good title? The title should indicate your most important results or discovery. What is the most important thing that you have discovered? That is very, very important. That you should reflect. So you should be very careful in choosing that. It should also reflect your purpose in writing. Why you have written that. Ask yourself, what is the main point you wish to make? That is very important. When you start doing research, maybe MPhil, thesis, PhD, whatever, research paper also. You have some desire, you have some passion, you have some idea, which you want to tell to the world, yes, I want to do this. That should be appropriately reflected in the title. Your guide, your evaluator, your mentor, your expert, your senior will not give you ready-made words or suggest you do this, do that. It's you who is going to coin the title. So ask yourself, what is the main point you wish to make? What new information does your study contribute? And a good title is a specific, informative, and very, very, very important, very provocative. It should trigger to provoke the ideas in the mind of the reader. So it triggers the thinking and more reflections are made out of it. That is very, very important. So again, I repeat this. The title is the first thing a reader sees. A boring title turns readers away, and good title will determine whether to read it or not. If you understood, then please see to it that it really makes some sense for you. Now, let us say that you have completed and undergone a process of evaluation, and your experts, your referee, your guide, they are telling you that your title, there is some problem with your title. Would you please meet your teacher? Would you please meet your mentor? Would you please meet your expert? Correction is required. What correction? You please better consult your expert. You know, that is the way you are told. But in this entire process, you should also understand, what is wrong with my title? So generally, what happens with the titles is that it is too long, the title. So the problem for me is that to make understanding clear and much better for my own, you can say, perception, the length of the title kills the meaning of it. Second problem with the title is that it doesn't comprehend the work. It's a good title, interesting, catchy, but you have done a lot of work and that work is not comprehended properly. Comprehension is such a concept which will, in very less and appropriate words, describe what you have done. Sometimes the title is not at all appropriate. Not at all appropriate. But you have given it and you forgot to correct it or check it or evaluate it. Postgraduate level students especially, they are confused with a lot of grammar part of it. Grammatical correction is necessary for your title. And there they make a lot of fun, a lot of, you can say, trouble. And so it becomes a great insult to your mentor or teacher. And he gets wild on you or she gets wild on you because they would always quote that, you know, such a small thing you cannot understand. How come you have done such a great work? But it is true. You can do great work, big work, huge work, but you forget small things. And that is the biggest trouble because again, title is a cover. If cover is not good, nobody is going to open it, nobody is going to bother it, nobody is going to respect you and give you the price of all your work. That is very important. Sometimes the title is good, it's not lengthy also, but it doesn't give justice. Not just work, but whatever topic you have chosen, it's not justifying everything that you have done into it. And apart from that, title also has another error called other specific reason that title is not suiting your thesis, your research paper, your report, your study report or your SIP, whatever is there. I look at it from a very different point of view. Your title is too long and somebody is laughing, somebody is crying, somebody is confused and somebody is feeling awesome. It's not something that, you know, should be an entertaining material for the reader. Title should be simply taking a very close look at the reader's interest and connect him to the content. So in this case, I believe that something connected to grammar and something connected to our understanding of this work, we require some corrections into the way we look at it. The problem, especially when you are using English as the language, is prepositions. Here is a diagram, if you can just see here. When you use on, you can just look at the picture. When you use in, look at the picture. When you say next to, besides, look at the picture. In front of, behind, between, under, through, and around. Do you find that some of these words in this particular slide, are they familiar to you? And then you'll find that you have just created a title like shunting of a train, you know, keeping all the words as the bogies, one after another, but the trouble is, engine is connected at the last, and the guard's bogie is in the front. Or sometimes, you know, these particular, you can say, prepositions which you use to connect the words to form the title are wrong. So put your title here, I have just put it here in the slide, and just compare if you have used on properly, if you have used in properly, if you have used through properly, or under the guidance of whatever is there in your work, have you done it properly or not? If you just look at it from that point of view, you will come to know that yes, I have to work on the appropriate use of prepositions in my title. That is the first rule. And then next is, there is some science and there is some basic understanding. So I just put here a list of all the prepositions. When you use to, that is, you know, to describe the present continuous, to be, and then, you know, want to use different types of verbs. I'm not going to read them all, but just to make some sense of how we really use all such words, I want you to understand. Adapt to, add to, agree to, apologize to. So how we use to here, how we use for, admire for, apologize for, apply for, ask for. How do we use from? Most of the time we describe time period, and in time period what we do is nothing else but we say from this date to that date. In finance, you say from this date to that date, whatever is there. So, you know, from also has some great significance when it is properly put into your discussion. So what is that? So abstain from, borrow from, escape, graduate, hide. So when you say I'm graduated, when you say in so and so college, you always say graduated from a particular place. See, you can understand small or big mistakes like that. Hide from, infer from, prevent from, prohibit from, like that. On is a very funny but true, truly troubling preposition when we use it. Whether the study is on something or in something is a big trouble for all the researcher. You agree on or you agree upon, based on, be on, blame on, comment on, concentrate on, congratulate on, so many things are there. It depends on how you are really going to use this particular thing in your work. When it is a research paper, you have to be very particular, because the audience is going to be very different and they are peer reviewers who will bother about your language and the grammar part. When it is evaluation, you are going to get some marks and there is a viva or something there also. Very simple grammatical mistake or wrong connection of on can lead to wrong meaning of a title, and so your evaluation will go down. Title will be okay, but marks will be less. How do you go about using about? Again, I would say to argue about, ask about, be about, boast about. So people get confused in using about and regarding. So always say regarding this, regarding that. See, English has so many variety of different words and it is being used all over the world. So it has a different combination of culture, grammar and context. Here when you are doing research, context is important. Aashay tumcha mahatvacha aahe, baghnare vachnare kon aahe he mahatvacha aahe. So you should be very careful, especially when you are using regarding or about something. Which appears very simple, but it is troublesome. To acquaint with, agree with, associate with, charge with, clutter with, coincide with, so many things. Trust with. So you have